flow, but we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a suffer. Made it to the top flow, but we started from the gutter.
To be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Just as we were ready for air, it was the Colts emerging from the locker room to great fanfare here at Indy. They're ready to go as the Colts get set to match up with the Seattle Seahawks. ready to get us started. The Aussie punter and kickoff man, Michael Dixon. And we are underway here on EA Sports. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Here's Taylor. And that's not the start that he was looking for, as he's going to be met and dropped behind the line. It'll go as a loss of a yard on the game's first play. Second down. They'll run the toss here with Taylor. And a big play there on second down, but we do have a flag on the field. This is in the area where it might be coming back. They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. Out of the gun, McDonald. Looking for Campbell downfield. He's got a man complete. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Well, fair to say that when you're looking at guys that can run like the wind, you often find him at the wide receiver position, and that was special there. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good, and that makes the score 7-0. So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. Fielded just outside the goal line. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at their own 26. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
Something to watch here in week one of the season, tackling. Because you and I both know that in the preseason, a lot of these guys don't play a whole lot. Plus, the intensity and the speed really ratchets up on opening week.
They go back to Carson here on second, and he'll be brought down right around the 37. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
First down, it's Carson, and he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that field. I'm like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
So for this defense, a tall order had tried to defend against Russell Wilson. Charles, your keys for how they might go about keeping him in check?
Well, before we even get to the keys, let's start with the problems he presents, because he feels pressure so well. He's got a great sixth sense, maybe even a 7th and 8. He knows where the pressure's coming from. He knows how to slide away from it, sometimes run away from it, and then he finds good throwing lanes to deliver downfield. So to me, it's that pressure inside, big, tall guys to make him try and throw over them and make his height work against him.
And running with power here. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. It's a gain of 12, first down Seahawks. You were telling me this yesterday. That's exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation? We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Flushed out right. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell in.
And he'll go down, brought down at the 20-yard line. Quinny Pay brings him down, and that's a play he's going to remember. The first sack of his NFL career. Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. Being chased out left. And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark him down at the 9. A solid run of 11 there as he tucked in and ran, but he's still short of the marker at its 4th. They'll try and throw for it with Wilson. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. Touchdown! Chris Carson, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Seahawks just an extra point away from tying this thing up. It took a pretty big risk right there going for it on 4th down. But, hey, not only did they get the first down, forget about that, they got in the end zone.
Yeah, because normally you're just thinking, can I get enough yardage to get it past the sticks and pick up a first down? Instead, they go for the end zone and get it done with no margin for error. Remember, 4th down, they went for it.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And this will be a touchback as Ed Sales over the end line. Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. They were successful last time finding the end zone on their opening drive of the season. And they'll get another shot here with a 1st and 10. Oh, he's got some breathing room. It'll go as a gain of 25 on a play that started back at the 25.
That's the type of run that Jonathan Taylor gives you so often, and you just can't take it for granted. He finds a way to get those extra yards. The 3rd running back taken the 2020 draft, but he had the best numbers by far of any of them. 1,169 yards, 3rd most in the NFL, and by the last quarter of the season, he ranked among the best runners in the league.
They will get 4 yards here on the 1st down run, and that'll make it 2nd and 6. Seven, seven, our score after one. Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. They give to Taylor out of the gun. They'll get only a couple down to the 44.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you, and sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the plays we just saw there.
We saw a great, great example of perseverance right there on that play.
Got to be careful. They might want to throw one over his head as this game progresses.
McDonald. They'll set up the screen to Taylor. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Indianapolis moving the chains there on a gain of 12.
I like the play design there. They occupied the defense downfield, everyone trying to account for someone. But unfortunately, they didn't account for the running back slipping out of the backfield. And he was absolutely unnoticed and wound up getting big yards on that play.
They'll run it here. This is Marlon Mack. And Bobby Wagner, the all-pro, in on the tackle.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're a back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
Here's Mack to get it again on second down. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
First and 10, Taylor now. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. When we call them run fits, everyone was in the right place.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. From the gun, it's Taylor. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness. He's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Now play number 8 on this drive. And they need 9 yards to pick up the first on third. McDonald sets to throw. To the right side, complete to Taylor. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. He loses 4, and it brings up 4th. Blankenship's kick is good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. So good kick there, and they put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defenses are awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the turn.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow.
Either way.
Not the tie, but yeah.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
45 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here's second and a yard from the 34. This is Carson, and he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
I know what you're thinking out there. I know a lot of you are thinking, take a shot downfield. It's a great spot for it. I'd say maybe later in the game, definitely in the second half. But right now, I think they were just trying to get some momentum built. Get a first down, pick it up, and keep moving.
And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. Now they'll throw it with Wilson. Finds a seam inside the 40. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. Instead of the first, he'll have to go backwards for another 2nd down try.
So if there is a silver lining, though, it stays 2nd down. And they still have an opportunity to pick up a 1st down before they have to start their downs over again.
They run it with Carson. Now he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on 1st down. 1:57 to go in this first half on EA Sports. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll again head down to visit with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando, back for another year. He'll have scores from around the NFL here on this opening weekend. Powers through it, fights off the defender, and he's going to get this inside the 30. 11 yards there and a first down for Seattle. But you said it earlier in the quarter when we saw a broken tackle then that we might see some missed tackles here early on in week one, and that's another one right there.
Yeah, not a surprise at all. It will even out as the season expands.
And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Dwayne Eskridge with his first career touchdown in his first career game. And the Seahawks are going to retake the lead. Extra point up and through by Myers. And the lead is now 14-10. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just, I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. Throwing is McDonald. Looking for Campbell downfield. And this is caught. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. So it's first and goal and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. They'll look to run with Taylor. And he is going to lose yardage here. Now the Seahawks call the second of their three timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Again, it'll be Taylor. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Jonathan Taylor punching it in from a yard away. And the Colts are once again going to retake the lead. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good. And it's now 17-14. So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And with a little under a minute to go, they may try and work their way into field goal range and try to tie up this ball game. Catch is made by Metcalf. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. Call that a very strong gain of 24. Now it's Wilson. It's caught. Lockett. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Throwing again on second down. Wilson flush to his right. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. 5 yards on the scramble, and that's enough to pick up the first. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Here's Carson. Takes this to the 32, maybe the 31, and then the defense rallying quickly after that broken tackle. And now a timeout defensively after that first down play. So they're going to make this offense sweat out half number one. And Myers able to knock it through. And that will do it for this first half. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
Play action. It's Wilson. And that almost their first INT of the ball game. Had his sights on it, but he couldn't seal the deal. So, Charles, tie game here. What are your keys as we continue to play this second half?
I know people think it's always trite when you say the same things over and over, but they're tried and true in the game of football. Who's going to block better? Who's going to tackle better? In this case, to me, it's turnovers. You've got to take care of the football in order to win the game.
And he will not get there as they stop him short right around the 34-yard line. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up a fourth down. Now here's Michael Dixon. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. The drive will start with an option going left. And he will slide to a halt with a penalty marker down on the play. So they'll walk him back half the distance. Here's McDonald to throw. That ball caught by Campbell. He's at the 40. The 20. Touchdown, Indianapolis.
He can beat you in a number of ways. He can catch it short. He can take it longer. He can do what we just saw right there. Catch it and then run with the football.
Plenty of praise on the play, but this is also a bit of a breakdown defensively because you got to be right on him when he makes the catch. Otherwise, he has the ability to really make you pay, and he does right there, picking up excellent real estate after the catch.
Extra point by Blankenship is up and good, and they will take a 7-point lead. So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Now on second and 13, Wilson.
Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted.
Picked up by Kenny Moore. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line.
And those are the types of plays that Kenny Moore wants to make more of, because he's really starting to make a name for himself, and many know him as a terrific blitzer from the nickelback position. Undrafted out of Valdosta State, he is a ball hawk as well, and he led the Colts with four picks in 2020.
And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line.
44 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just
going
to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Jonathan Taylor. And the Colts are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good, and the lead now up to 14. So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. Eskridge going to keep this one in the end zone, and they'll start at the 25-yard line. Into the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. Wilson eluding the pressure right. And he fires one that's intercepted. He's picked off at his own 47. And the return stops at the 39-yard line.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage. But instead, he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They'll start by running the option to the right. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. He lost 6 there on the first down play.
Well, that play never really got off the launching pad. He had a linebacker in his face before he had a chance to do much of anything.
Yeah, I think it's big boys up front, that offensive line. They've got to do a little bit better job of protecting him if they're going to continue to run the option like this.
Got some real estate inside the 30 and down to the 19-yard line. A big hitter there, a first down gain of 26 yards. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Here's Taylor. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
The short field shrinks even more with the type of bodies they brought in on that play. Those extra tight ends, they weren't able to secure their blocks, and that one ended up going backwards.
On second down now, it's Taylor. 5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with third and about 6 yards to go.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
On third down, here's Taylor. And they're going to lose some on this play. Being knocked back to the 18. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down. Blankenship's kick is good, and that will extend their lead even further. So the turnover leads to points as they add 3 there.
Yeah, what a sequence there, and a nice one for them. They force the interception, put together a little drive, and then come away with 3 points. Nothing to it, partner. Just do it.
coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense.
Now they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation. Now it's Wilson. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
And that's well executed there on 3rd down, and I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field, right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a 1st down.
Now here's a pass on 1st down that's knocked away and incomplete.
And that's a nice job there, because you've got to play the ball, not the man, when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties, and he's able to knock that one away.
2nd and 10, 3rd quarter of the season opener. Now Wilson. To the right side, incomplete to Metcalf. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another 1st down at the Colts' 44-yard line. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's 1st and 10. Wilson will throw again. They'll run the screen with Carson. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it, because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen, where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
Meanwhile, Wilson's throw into the hands of Lockett, and they'll get him to the ground. He has another 1st down at the Colts' 12-yard line. A good pickup there, a 22. From down at the 12, it's 1st and 10. And Wilson's going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off inside the 10. And he'll bring it all the way back, just a yard or two shy of midfield.
Well, offensively, Charles, hard to put a silver lining on this one. No secret that they had to take chances with a score where it is, and it leads to a turnover.
I love how you paint the picture, partner, because you're exactly right about that one. Look at the empty stares on that sideline. This is one of those games where you just want to go crawl under a rock until it's over.
They'll run with Taylor to begin the drive. Pushes him over, and he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. 103 yards rushing for him now as he goes over the century mark here in the season opener. Second down, another run with Taylor. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line. That one, a 1st down pickup of 8.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a 1st down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. That really sets them back. A loss of 6. 2nd and 16. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. They lose 2 on that last play, so things get even tougher. 3rd and long coming up. Looking to throw. McDonald escaping the pressure right. Airs it out toward the corner of the end zone. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on 3rd down. So that one will be accepted. Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. And this will be up to the ruling of the side judge here. He says it crossed out of bounds at the 16-yard line. Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at their own 16.
He gives it off to Carson.
And he'll lose yardage here, back to the 15. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. From the shotgun, Wilson. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. It's a gain of 22 as we tick towards 2:22 on the clock. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. To throw is Wilson. Flushed out right. And he'll be out of bounds after his short pickup, as that's going to take us to the two-minute warning. Working with second and 5 now. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. That'll go as a pickup of 32 on the catch and run. On first and 10, it's Wilson. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
This defense was definitely of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Wilson after the play fake to Carson. Going for it all. And this is going to be intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a great return as they're finally able to take him down. If they had designs of kind of wiggling their way back into this one, that hurts their chances right there.
Yeah, to put it mildly, we look at the lead, look at the deficit, trying to make a play downfield. Everyone seeking to be somewhat the hero. Didn't turn out that way at all, and you're exactly right. It's going to take a lot for them to have a chance to win this one now.
They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Looks like he'll throw here. He'll buy some time right. And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. And give him 10 that time as he was able to get away from the pressure and get a nice gain.
I like his thought process and his ability to move and get downfield. But what I didn't like was the final decision to go out of bounds. They want to keep the clock moving. Instead, they give the defense an extra timeout.
They'll try and run for the first with Taylor. And Taylor, I don't think he got there. No, he did not. Unable to break free, and he's marked short. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as it comes with exactly a minute to go in the football game. As Sanchez on to punt here as he sends this one away. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt, and it'll be Seahawk football first and 10. At their own 39-yard line. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they knew coming in that this would be a tough place to go in and win a season opener. But this has just been a performance, to be frank, not to be... And this is taken in at the 5. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. DK Metcalf, 61 yards. And the Seahawks have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth. Myers connects on the PAT, and the lead is trimmed down to 10. Seahawks 24. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. carry by Taylor to start the drive. Shedding through the defense. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. He was close to flirting with that sideline, but able to stay in bounds like you know his coach wants him to do and keep that clock moving.
Isn't it funny that we're watching this play when we had that discussion just yesterday about this? What do you do in this scenario? What do you, you know, what's your mindset? It appeared to me that he'd totally forgotten that he needed to stay in bounds. And then the last second, oh, no, I better get down. And he ended up doing the right thing. But at that point, maybe close to letting it slip away.
So this one winds up an Indianapolis victory. And with that, our journey begins, Charles. Week 1 in the books. Going to be a great season.
Oh, man, so much to look forward to. Isn't it nice to get a really good game right out of the gate? Preseason behind us. All these games count now, don't they?
Yeah, this is the exciting time with just 1 week gone and plenty of weeks to come. So for Indianapolis, that'll be a happy locker room as they start this season 1-0. And they'll have another home date next week as the LA Rams come to town.
Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a tutor. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real.
They say,
on God,
only ever care about one thing.
Jesus.